Hey guys, press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from Pinkvilla.
Hey guys, this is me, Avantika, and yet again we're in another episode with Neha Ranglani, who is our health nutrition educator. And so hello, how are you?
Hi Avantika, I'm very well, thank you.
So we're going to talk about stress. First up, tell me, what is your opinion on stress and how it's just spreading across?
So I always say we are the fish in the water who don't know we are wet.
Oh.
You know, so we are those beings who are always stressed and we don't know we are stressed, because that's become a part of our nature. It's become a part of our being, you know. I mean, today even kids who are like 2 and 3 and 5 and 6 have stress. So the whole atmosphere that we live in is very stressful, is very competitive, is very, intimidating. So that's why I think we are always stressed.
Yeah.
And I always say it's, you know, your tan, man and your an, the three factors which cause a lot of stress.
So I think it's a known fact that stress damages us. But what I want to ask you is, how does it damage our body?
So stress actually is a very, very positive response to our survival. So imagine you have a lion in front of you. You're going to either fight or you're going to flight. So that is stress. I mean, your body is in a stress mode and the body does everything to help you survive and sustain. But today it's become so common, like we have a lion in front of us all the time. Now in this condition, what happens is whenever you're stressed, your body produces adrenaline, which is a stress hormone, right? And when the stress hormone is up, your other functions in the body stop for a while. So your digestion, your excretion, your other processes which are not important for survival, they will take a backseat, because your body has to deal with more important stuff like your heartbeat, you know, your liver doing the work, all of that, because your body has to keep you going. So all the extra energy which the body releases from your muscles and your liver, it goes to your entire cells so that they can use up and fight the stressful situation.
Okay.
But now we have stress all the time. So all the time our adrenaline is high. So clearly the other functions in our body are not doing well, you know. So that's why all our organs get damaged. Other than that, adrenaline is very, very corrosive and acidic for our body.
Okay.
It's a hormone which helps you survive, but it also has its repercussions. So the liver is a very smart organ. So what the liver does is it absorbs the excess adrenaline. So in the bargain, your other organs also get damaged, like your liver, your pancreas, your kidneys will suffer, your gut will suffer. Stress basically damages every aspect of your being.
I want to know, what are the different kinds and types of stress that there are?
Yeah. So in our daily life, we come across a lot of mental and emotional stresses, like your fear, aggression, irritability, nervousness, anger, happiness. There are a lot of emotions, and then there are situations which kind of make you stressed out. So arguments, fights, deadlines, pressures, you know, having a divorce, going through a divorce, or losing a loved one, or breakup, or whatever. These are all emotional situations. So these are the kind of stresses. Then you have physical stress. So physical stress is, one, your food. So under-eating, overeating, eating the wrong kind of foods, you know, having a lot of alcohol, having a lot of colas, packaged foods, high fat diet, fasting for long hours. This is kind of stress for the body. Over exercising, under exercising, overworking, all of this is stress for the body. So there has to be a balance which we need to create, and that our body exactly tells us when it's getting stressed, but all we need to do is we need to listen to our body.
Okay, so like you said, we have to listen. How do we tackle it, you
know?
For example, if I'm in an office setup and you know things can get like really stressful in an office setup, how can one person be like, okay, this is what I have to go to, this exercise, and I know I'll be okay in 5 minutes?
Absolutely, we can definitely tackle stress in much more productive ways. So the first one is your food. Like I said, the wrong food also creates stress in the body. No food also creates stress in the body. So you need to eat your carbs. Your glucose is the most important thing, most important fuel for your car to run. Your car is your body. And another very important way to deal with stress is focusing on your breath.
Okay.
Our breath is our best friend, but it's the most taken for granted function or activity of our body. We don't really think of our breathing too much. It's just like your car, you know, your car, when you run it for a very long time, it gets heated up. So you shut the car and you kind of cool the engine down so that you can run longer.
Yeah.
It's just like that. When we are very stressed out, when we don't, when we have too many things around us, when we don't breathe well, our brain gets heated up. So we need to shut ourselves up and we need to cool down, we need to relax so that all the functions of the body can happen again properly. So here are a few exercises which I can show you right away. Whatever you're doing, you can do these exercises. So I think we can begin now.
Yep, can't wait. Let's do this.
The first one is, focus on your breath. Sit in a quiet place uninterrupted or undistracted, either on a chair or cross-legged on the floor. Close your eyes and start breathing. Start with inhaling and simply exhaling and counting from 1 to 5 on every exhale. Inhale, exhale, count 1. And repeat this till you reach 5. After 5, go back to 1 and count again till 5. You can repeat this for 3 to 5 times. The second one is belly breathing or deep breathing with 4, 7 and 8 counts. To start, put one hand on your belly and the other hand on your chest. Take a deep breath from your belly and silently count to 4 as you breathe in. Hold your breath and silently count up till 7. Breathe out completely as you silently count up till 8. Try to get all the air out of your lungs by the time you come to the count 8. Repeat this from 3 to 5 times or till you feel calm and relaxed. The third one is, drop yourself down, relaxation. Stand up in a comfortable position. Stretch your arm upwards and throw yourself down with your head downwards in a loose, relaxed manner without trying to touch the floor. Go down as comfortable as possible. Take 10 deep breaths while you're in that position. Roll up one vertebrae at a time. Stretch your arms again and relax. The fourth one is Om chanting relaxation. All you need to do for this is lie down on the floor with your legs up on the chair or on the bed, making sure that your knees are at 90 degrees angle. Place your fingers on your eyes and close your ears with your thumb. From there, inhale and exhale, chanting Om till you can continue with the M sound. Om is a universal sound and your cells feel aligned and relaxed when you chant Om. Do the Om chanting for 7 to 10 times or till you feel relaxed.
So thank you so much, Neha.
Thank you, Vantika.
You have no idea, I'm so sure you have no idea how many people you've helped today with this video.
My pleasure. Yeah. That's what my work is all about.
Do let us know if you want us to tap on any, you know, topics that you want. And also do comment below with your queries. Neha, as usual, is going to answer everything. Until next time, we'll see you. Bye-bye.